Hello friends, this is Frank from Germany and we are close to a perfect PNP machine, but I think I need 1 or 2 months. I'm a little bit worried about the calibrating this machine and so on. But first of all, I want to show you the camera widget. I tune it a little bit up to use a normal MJPEG stream. And yes, I want to show you this. The next one is I want to show the PNP header. He's close to complete. Also, I show you my MOSFET driver, how he switch on the vacuum pump, in special the vacuum solenoid. Then we have also a little session about the run out of the nozzle and how I can compensate this in the code. And yes, don't speak about it. Do it. So now you see here our normal chili pepper, and that's the new chilipepper.com PCP Tiny G. And I have a little Raspberry Pi. He is connected in my basement on a WLAN, and now you see here he is running. And also very interesting is here user bin motion. This is our new small webcam standard program. You can use this, and this will present a stream, an MJPEG stream. And I change a little bit the camera widget. You see this here. Now, for the first time, you can see you can set the MJPEG URL. That's mine, 192. You see, it's my local network, and it's on the stream. It's on the port 8081. The X offset and the Y offset is the center of the camera and to the center of the spindle. Yes, this is the offset. You see here, it's in X direction minus 24.8 and in Y offset 37.1. In the next video session, I want to show you how you can discover the offset from your camera, but for the first time, you see you need only the MJPEG URL. If you have this MJPEG URL, then you can here open and you see my camera stream. You see also the time and so on. You can put this in the configuration file for motion. And the good thing is, you can switch off and switch on. And the good thing is, I want to also add a function. If you close this, then it will automatically switch off. I don't know why, but I think if you watch here my top, you see motion now needs 40% of the CPU. It's a lot. When we check this with HTOP, you see I have a new Raspberry Pi. It's with 4 cores, and you see I have here the motion, two processors with 24%, 37. It's a lot, but I checked this. I think my configuration file is not perfect now. And the good thing is, if you move, wait, I must move my video to the other side. If you move the machine, then you can see that the camera will also change. And with a little crosshair in the middle, you can discover your offset. My camera is not so good. It's only a very cheap endoscope camera from China with 350 to 240 pixels. It's trash, yes, but you see, it's good enough. I think for the best for the best time, it's you get another endoscope with 2 MP, and then you have our picture from 640 to 480. It's very good, or bigger. Yes, HD, it's very cool. Okay, next time in my basement. See you. Now here you see my first tests to switch on and off this solenoid. This has 12 volts and an 1.2 watts. It's very cheap. It's cost here in Germany maybe $1 or $2. And this is connected to my MOSFET driver. You get this here in Germany for $4 or $5. It's a PCB with all the elements, and you have to solder this yourself. And you see the ground wire is switched and the plus wire go to the normal plus. Yes, that's a special thing because this MOSFETs, this little MOSFETs here, this very tiny MOS guys here, they switch to maximum, I think, 24 volts with 3 ampere. It's unbelievable. It's very cool. And you have also an optocoupling system here, optocoupler. They are galvanic isolated from our Arduino. So Arduino himself, it's running with my Gerbil firmware 9.9 for the second controller. Yes, you switch the vacuum pump on, and he rotate the vacuum stepper, and also he rotates the stepper for the auger pump and so on. You see forward, we have three axes, additional three axes here, and can use this as second controller and chili pepper. And but we see forward, you see this in the future, but now we have only connected to the coolant pin, it's A3, and to the ground pin. Now I want to demonstrate how it switched on and off. Then you see here the comments. M8 switched this off, switched this on. I hope. You hear the little cluck. No, it's not so bad. I can switch off the lamp. And then you see it switched on. The little LED you see here, it's light. Yeah, this one, it's light. And now we switch this off. And it's off. So it works. Now we can demonstrate, we make a little demonstration with my very cheap aquarium pump from China. And you get all these silicon pipes and here for your hands. Yes, this is glue tape. Behind this glue tape, it's a hole. You can put this, you can close this with your fingers and so on, but I don't want. So now you see here, it's a little chip, and we can do what we like. Nothing. The suction is off, the solenoid, the vent here is closed, but now we open it. So, and now we can put our little SMD components, place it on a new place, put it to the ground, and you have to wait a little bit. Now, 3, 2, 1. And you see, after 1 or 2 seconds, it will fall down. This is because we don't use a second vent here, because the best thing is we have a second vent here. This close and this make it open. And no, this close, this make it, yeah, this make open and let the vacuum out. I hope I explain this a little bit. Because if you close this vent here, then you have a little bit vacuum in your silicon pipe, and you have to wait that it comes a little bit air. If you have a very dicht system, then you can wait whatever you want. the component will not fall. Now we think about it, we test a little bit, but now you see it works very nice. With a coolant M8 and M9. Here a second demonstration. So now, na? Now it works. Yeah, I can put it wherever I like. And now we switch off. And you have to wait a little bit, and then it's falling down. So now I want to show you how we clamp
our platform on the wasteboard. Yeah, you know, we use broken end mills and so on. You see also, it's a little bit, you see a curve here. It's not really planned, but I put new three holes for M5 screws. And first of all, we put our board to the things. I have here some broken mills. So now we take this one. So put this here. Then we see one hole here. Zack. And the next one. Well, we take this one. Put this here and zack. Now we have the very accurate position and we can screw in the holes. So, and now we can remove the end mills here. And if you are unsure it's accurate or not, you can test this with the other holes. It's perfect here, perfect, and also here. And now you can use it. So here you see the stepper with the metric gauge, and if I the measure cylinder it's touched on the nozzle, and if I rotate my stepper, and then you see the run out. You can mark the highest run out here with the scala, with the scale. So now it's null, and you can go back and you see, yeah, our run out, it's 9.83 millimeter. And the best is the lowest point, you mark this on your adapter. That's the lowest point, and you see here it's close to the screw, and now we can mark this on our adapter. Rotate. The lowest is important because we want put this stepper with the lowest point in the front of the machine. Yes. And this means we have to now where the lowest point. And if we move this to the other, okay, maybe somebody has problems to calculate this. Then we can also put the scale on the lowest point, rotate, and then you see we have 76, 75. 9.75 millimeter run out. Maybe, yeah, a little bit less. Right here are the null. So, and now 77. So, hello, friends. Now you see. I work a lot on our PNP header, and I want to a little bit explain what you see here now. That's a little NEMA 8 stepper with the adapter for Yuki nozzle. This is a Yuki nozzle 593, and if you watch this very good in this video, you see I have a lot of run out. I think maybe 9.5 millimeters, that's too much. I need a solution for this, but it's on the way. You see also we have here the signal wires. They go to the up to a Gerbil Arduino. I want to show this in a second session now. And here you see also 3D printed, also with this. This is also you can see this. This is a 3D printed access for our NEMA 14 stepper. And you see also it's very short to the auger pump. The auger pump go here. Here are our reservoir, and the auger pump is here on the bottom. You see also it's not the same level but close to. And that's my plan. I want to put this here on the same level. We see forward, it's possible or not. Or we need a mechanism. He pull the stepper or this one up and down. But I don't want. Simple as possible. We try it so. Then you see also the second. And now I want to show you the electronics. So now you see the electronics. This is a normal Arduino with the Arduino enclosure. You can get this, I think, for $5 to $10. It's good for me. It's made in plastic. We can put another one on the other side. And you see also very cheap Gerbil shield. This, I get this in China for $3.50. Very cheap, very cool. Two driver. I prefer the DFO 8865 driver, it's better for me and so on. They also tested on my power supply in the bureau and works very well. The tip is make microstep 16, also here 16, and then it's very smooth. You have a lot of steps to move the stepper, and it's better if you sometimes you lost one step, and this is not so important if you have 16 micro steps. Also you can see the cables go to our steppers here. Also little advice, okay, the stepper, and you have to change the potentiometers here. The little stepper here, the NEMA 8, use for one coil 600 milliamperes. You have two coils, then you can calculate you need 1.2 ampere. Unbelievable. The same here, 800 per coil. This means 1.6 ampere. I want to power supply all with 12 volt because my solenoid for air, this one here, needs, you see this here, very good, needs 12 volts, here 12 volts at 100 milliampere, it's not so much, but I want to power this steppers, power the solenoid only with one power supply, and this means 12 volt and I think 3 ampere, it's enough. You see also my MOSFET driver, it's a little bit, I screw this here on this enclosure, but I need a second way. This will switch on and off the vacuum solenoid, and we have a little aquarium pump. This will produce the vacuum. Okay, I hope you like it, and next week we will see, maybe it's run. Okay, bye-bye.